My mother taught me to play chess when I was 5. She said, in chess you have freedom to think. My childhood dream was to be the world champion. I won against opponents older and taller than I was, and I felt good. When the Soviets locked me in a punishing cell, they tried to break my spirit. They thought that it would break me mentally and intellectually. But I ran thousands of chess games in my mind, and I won every time. In chess, when you give up one of your pieces, you have to know why you made that sacrifice. What is your main goal? Only a person who is free inside can make a change in the world. I knew I was part of an historic struggle by the Jewish people to be a free nation in our land. My wife gave me a book of Tehillim, Psalms, which I cherished. I tried to understand what it said in Hebrew, and the very first sentence I understood in full was Psalm 23. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. I fought hard for my identity and my freedom, to remain free, to go to Israel, to my people, and to my wife. I grew up without a Jewish identity. The only Jewish thing in my childhood was anti-Semitism, and it taught me the importance of the connection between Israel and the diaspora. In chess, you have to be able to anticipate threats before they become dangerous. And today the biggest threat to the Jewish people is ourselves. Our connections to each other are weakening, and if you lose those connections, our survival as one people will be threatened. The first goal I set for myself when I got to Israel was to help all those who were left behind. This required us to continue our pressure on the Soviet Union to grant its citizens human rights, including Jewish rights. Together with other prisoners of Zion and Aliyah activists, I established the Zionist Forum, and it became a lobby for immigrants' rights. I established an Alim party and entered politics in 1996 to promote the integration of 1 million immigrants into Israeli society. In all my public positions, I worked to build a strong bridge between Israel and world Jewry. So it was a natural move afterwards to head the Jewish agency. I believe that one universal quality of identity is that it gives life meaning beyond life itself. At the Jewish Agency, I have worked to strengthen global Jewish identity by strengthening the ties of our people around the world. We instituted programs that bring more Jews to Israel and more of Israel to Jewish communities. Strengthening Jewish identity and Jewish connections is a strategic process and our true challenge. My years at the Jewish Agency have been very fulfilling to me. The idea for Israeli campus fellows came to me during the Second Intifada, when we realized the incredible gap between us Israelis, who are fighting terror and stand at the forefront of the global struggle against terrorism, and young Jews on university campuses, who are embarrassed and confused by anti-Israel propaganda. I see the Jewish agency Shlichim as soldiers on the front lines of defense. One of the most meaningful things for me was posting Shlichim to university campuses. A Jewish agency shalir delivers our message, makes connections, ties us together. I loved the challenge of playing chess against many opponents simultaneously, a challenge often faced in real life. Today the Shlichim must do many things at once, facilitate Aliyah, educate, fight anti-Semitism, and strengthen Jewish identity. To succeed, they need broader and more substantial training. To do this, we decided to create the Shlichut Institute. The Shlichut Institute in Jerusalem will train them to be excellent emissaries. They will learn how to set goals, plan their moves, reach their targets, and start their roles better prepared than before. Now it's time for the young generations to continue our work and promise our common future. I'm sure that they will do so no less than us. Dear friends, none of you is a pawn on the board. You are our queens and kings. בהצלחה.